Okay, we're integrating trigonometry. What can I say? Here we go. So, it's pretty straightforward, if I'm totally honest. 4x dx. You could put the 3 out the front. That's not going to really be massively affected by the integration until right at the end. And then, differentiates to sine? Well, cosine differentiates to minus sine. So, there we go. So I'm going to have a minus cosine of 4x. But I'm also, because it's 4x, I need a quarter of that, because if I differentiated cosine of 4x, I'd end up with minus 4 sine 4x. So there we go. So I've got to have a quarter of that. Let's simplify all of that. Oh, and don't forget plus c. So we should have minus 3 quarters of cosine 4x plus c. All right, pretty straightforward. Now, actually, they give you this second one here in the formula book, right? But I was going to show you kind of where it comes from. If I say, well, hang on, it's sine x over cosine of x dx. Now, you'll notice that the top is almost the differential of the bottom, which means it's got something to do with the ln. Unfortunately, we're going to have a minus, so when I differentiate cosine, I get minus sine. So it's going to be minus ln of cosine x, and that's one of those chain rule backwards type things. So if I was to differentiate ln of cosine of x, I'd end up with minus sine x over cos x. All right, now I can rewrite that as, minus ln of cosine of x gives me ln of 1 over cosine of x plus c. And 1 over cosine of x we know is sec x. So there we go. That's where it comes from. But I literally, integrating trigonometry, really, really straightforward. They give you a load in the formula book, so make sure you check there first. And otherwise, you know that sine differentiates to cosine. You know that cosine differentiates to negative sine. So, yeah, jobs are good and really.